So today I'm going to be sharing you high-end products that I think are worth the price. I wanted to do this video because I know watching, you know, a bunch of beauty gurus on YouTube, I see like all of these high-end products that are really hyped up or that they're recommending to you. We all know that YouTubers with a big following like that do make a lot of money and a lot of that stuff gets sent to them and stuff. So I feel like as a very, very small YouTuber and kind of just a normal consumer, I could shed some insight into what is really truly worth the money, because for me, I feel like it is definitely a splurge, and I think sometimes it seems like for them it's not as big of a deal to spend that kind of money, or maybe they didn't even have to spend that kind of money. And I'm not saying that to like throw any hate or shade towards them, because I love all sorts of different beauty vloggers on YouTube. It doesn't matter if they're big or small. I don't think the bigger ones are more untrustworthy or anything like that, or that the smaller ones are more trustworthy. I'm not trying to say that. All I'm trying to say is that for people who are on more of a budget, spending a whole lot of money on makeup seems a lot more difficult than for people with a lot of extra money to spend on makeup and stuff. So that's all I'm trying to say, is that I don't have that extra money. I'm very broke, and definitely spending a lot on any makeup product is gonna be difficult for me. So I wanted to share with you what I think is worth the money and what I would basically buy again if I had to. So we're gonna go ahead and get on into it. First thing that I have here is the only non-makeup item that I have, and I actually forgot to put this in the thumbnail, so if you're wondering why it's not in the thumbnail, I just forgot to put it in. But anyway, this is a skincare item from Dr. Brandt, and I just have a little sample here. I haven't actually bought this one full size because it is expensive, but in my opinion it is worth the price, and if I ever have the money to spend on it, it is like $95 for the full size. If I ever have an extra $95 or however much it is, if I ever have that much extra income, then I will definitely go buy this. But right now I just don't have the money to be doing that. I'm saving up for a lot of stuff, so I'm kind of on a no-buy as it is. I'm not buying makeup right now at all. If I could buy this, I would. But anyway, the point is, if you can get a sample or whatever, I would try that first, for sure. And this little sample, it was a 100-point perk from Sephora, and it's lasted me a very, very long time. This is the Needles No More 3D Volumizing Mask, and I love this. It absolutely erases any fine lines or anything. You're putting it on, you are rubbing it upwards, and you can just see it lift your entire face, and I love it. I haven't used it in a while because I've just kind of forgotten about it, but it is absolutely amazing and 100% worth the hefty price tag. It's really expensive, but in my opinion, it is worth it, and it's something that I do want to splurge on one day. So moving along, nothing else in here is quite that expensive, thank goodness. Next, I want to talk about some eyeshadow palettes, because we see eyeshadow palettes from high-end companies all the time, and a lot of the time they're on YouTube, and people hype them up, and then they just kind of die down, and they don't really talk about them anymore, or they hype them up a lot, and you don't really know if it is worth that extra money. For me, I think eyeshadow is one of the harder things to find at the drugstore with good quality. There are definitely some good quality options, and if you want me to do a video all about that, I definitely will. There are a few high-end options for eyeshadow that I think are definitely worth the extra price, and they are, you know, better in quality and everything than anything you would find at the drugstore, in my opinion. First, I had the Urban Decay Naked Smoky palette. We've all heard about the Naked palettes. They got really hype. I have the Naked 3 and then this one, so I don't have like all of them to show you. I do think the Naked 3 is really pretty. In fact, I have that on my eyes today, but it's not something I would say is necessarily worth the price, because these are like around $54 or something like that, and in my opinion that one is good, but I think they're just as good at the drugstore. But this one is truly, truly amazing. I love it so much. This is what it looks like on the inside. Obviously, if you're not into smoky eyeshadows, this is not going to be the palette for you. It's called the smoky palette for a reason. But if you do want to do a nice smoky eye, and maybe you're newer at it, maybe you're just not great at smoky eyes, I'm not. So this one just makes it really easy, because these shadows are so blendable and so pigmented. It doesn't end up looking muddy or anything like that. These shadows are just really, really nice, and I think they make doing a smoky eye really easy. So I think for a makeup lover, this is a definite, it's not gonna say necessity, but it's definitely an asset to your collection for sure. So I feel like this is a really good option for your makeup collection, even if you don't wear smoky shadows every single day. I mean, that's not something I do every day, and that's why this palette isn't like extremely used as some of my palettes are. I have used this palette a lot and I really love it. You do have some more neutral shadows that you have the option to do more of a neutral eye and not necessarily a smoky eye, but you can do that as well. So I think it's really good, really versatile, and definitely something that any smoky eye lover would love to have in their collection. This is more of a new product to me. I've just recently got this for my birthday. This is the Anastasia Beverly Hills Modern Renaissance Palette. First of all, the packaging on this one, as well as the Naked Smoky, is just, they're so beautiful. This one is a nice, like, velvety feel, and it's a beautiful light pink, and then this one obviously has like the smoke behind it. It just looks so cool, which is another thing you kind of pay for with higher end products. So if you are somebody who's really into packaging, I really like packaging because I think it adds to the experience, then that's something that you're only gonna really get with higher end products. Back to this palette, this is a really beautiful palette. If you are a warm toned makeup lover or eyeshadow lover, you are going to absolutely die for this palette. If you love those fall cranberry, orangey, red shades, you are gonna love this so much. Eyeshadows themselves are really great quality. The mattes in here blend like a dream. They are so good. Very pigmented and very easy to work with. And my personal favorite thing in here is that just the shades are so different from your typical like neutral palette. You know, it's not just another neutral palette. It is something that's different and definitely stands out in my collection, which I think is worth the price. Just being that it is so unique and very pigmented and blendable, very easy to use. It also, both of these palettes that I've talked about come with a double-ended brush, so that's another thing that can kind of make it more worth the price, I think, and I just really love this one. This one I think was $42, so it is a lot less than the Naked one, by the way. Then I have the Tarlet and Bloom palette. I've talked about this many times on my channel. It is an amazing palette. It has my heart completely. This is what it looks like. It's definitely more of a neutral palette. A lot of the shades are matte, but I do think it's really a staple in anyone's collection. Packaging on this one is also beautiful, and the eyeshadows actually smell like vanilla, which is kind of like a weird thing, but I really like it. Eyeshadows in here are really easy to work with, easy to blend, and they don't have quite as much pigment as like the Anastasia one, for instance, where you kind of have to be like careful and very precise with where you're putting it. This one I feel like doesn't have quite as much, so it's a little bit easier for the beginner. You don't have to be quite as careful with them. At least that goes for the matte shades, and I feel like in here the shimmery shades are just really, really vibrant and beautiful and a little bit more pigmented than in the Anastasia one. I don't know why I'm comparing those two because they're not like at all similar, but I'm just saying that if you're looking for like a palette with a lot of mattes that is kind of more warm toned, they're similar in those ways, I guess. This one is also around the same price point. I think it was around $40. I just love this one a lot. I think there's a lot of things that you can do with it. You can definitely pair it with other palettes or with single eyeshadows, since there are so many mattes in here, but you can also create a look completely using this palette alone, and I just think it's really great. It's a really beautiful option. And the last palette that I want to talk about is the Lorac Pro Matte palette. This is a little like mini style palette. They do have the Lorac Pro palettes, but I don't actually have any of those. But if they are the same formula as this one, which I've heard that they are, I would recommend those as well. I really want to get one of those. This is probably my favorite eyeshadow formula. The thing about this is it does kick off a lot more powder, like it's very soft. Because of that, it just makes blending super easy. Colors are all really pigmented. It is one of those that you kind of have to be more careful with. But I like this palette in particular because you can pair it with like any eyeshadows that you already own. You can do a look just using these matte shades, but I would prefer to have at least a couple shimmery shades in there with it. I just think it's perfect as like a companion palette to other things, and I really love it. I would highly recommend it. I don't think this little one is very expensive. I think it's around 20. Okay, now we are getting into the rest of the makeup items. First is a very, very hyped makeup item that you might not have heard of in a while because I feel like it's kind of gotten pushed to the wayside, but back in the day, this was like a cult classic. This is the Hoola Bronzer from Benefit. You've probably heard of it. I have actually hit pan on this because I use it so much. I love it. I have it on today. I think it's just the perfect mix between like a warm and a cool toned. It's very like neutral. It works for like contouring, at least for me, and also for bronzing. So it's just a really, really great powder, and it just blends super easily. It's not like super duper pigmented right at first, so you're not gonna like accidentally put a stripe of orange on your cheek or whatever. It's not orange, but you get what I'm saying. So for me, this is really natural, easy to use, and I highly recommend it. It's definitely good for beginners. This was my first bronzer, I think, and it's something that I would 100% repurchase. I am trying to use this up this year, and eventually down the road, once I get through a few more bronzers, I would definitely repurchase this because this is probably my absolute favorite bronzer, to be honest. I think this is around $20 to $30. I should have looked that up before doing this video, but I will have everything linked in the description so you can go check them out and see how much they all are, and if you want to purchase any of them, like I said, they'll all be linked below. Next, I have a primer, and this one I feel like is definitely, definitely worth the money. I actually have a little mini size of it. I would recommend getting that if you can first, especially like for any of these, just so you can try it out before like committing to spending all of the money on this. Primers are something that I feel like is kind of more warranted to spend your money on because, first of all, there aren't that many options at the drugstore for primer. And second of all, some of us have a really hard time finding a primer that works for us. So what I'm talking about here is the Becca Evermatte Poreless Priming Perfector. That's a lot of P's. And for people with oily skin, it can be really hard to find a good primer to make your makeup last. This one is amazing. I have it on today. It makes your makeup last so long and definitely keeps your face looking flawless. And I mean, you might get a little bit oily, but definitely not as much as you normally would. I think it is the best primer that I've tried for oil control. I haven't really found one from the drugstore for that purpose that works well for me. This one just works really, really amazingly. So it comes in like almost like a lip gloss applicator thing, and I'm just gonna put a little bit on the back of my hand to show you kind of what it does. You definitely don't want to use too much of this at a time because it is super mattifying, but that's what it looks like, and then you just rub it in, obviously, like any primer did. I would recommend only kind of sticking this to the places that are gonna be really oily because it does mattify really, really intensely, so you don't want to put this in any area where there's not, where you don't get oily, you know? And I don't know if you can see, but this part of my hand just looks really mattified. It does have some glitter on it right now because I don't know, I guess I was messing with something that had glitter in it, so there's a little glitter, but there is no like sheen or anything. I don't know if you can really tell in the camera, but when I put this on, like in Sephora, I could just tell that my skin was perfected and mattified. I don't know how well you can see the difference there, but it filled in all the fine lines. My hand is super matte, and so if I put any makeup on this, it's not going anywhere. I'm not sure how much the price is for the full-sized one of that, but I know I got the little one for $15, so you can at least get one to try out, and it does last you quite a while. Then I have an eyeshadow primer, which is another thing that's really hard to find from a drugstore. I do have a little mini version of this as well. I haven't bought the full-sized yet, but I will once this one runs out. This one is a little 100-point perk from Sephora, and it has become my favorite eyeshadow primer ever. I actually don't have this on today, but whenever I use this, my eyeshadow just seems so much more vibrant, and it lasts all day long, no creasing, no worries about any of that. So I really love this. This is $20, I believe, for the full size, and I highly, highly recommend it. Next, I wanted to talk about Tarte blushes. I have this one here in Dazzled because it's the only non-limited edition blush that I have from Tarte. So I have tried a lot more of their blushes. They're just all limited edition, so I didn't want to show them to you since you can't get them. But this is in their permanent collection. It's a really pretty soft rose shade. I will swatch it, but they don't really swatch the best necessarily. It's kind of a drier formula, so it doesn't swatch the best. Like, it doesn't have a ton of pigment, but that's also kind of a good thing with blush, so you don't go overboard. What I really like about these is that they do stay in place all day. They don't have too much pigment where you're gonna end up with just like some kind of porcelain doll with really rosy cheeks or something. Like, I don't know, if that's what you want to do, then fine, but for me, that's not what I want to do. I like more subtle. You can really like build this up, build it down. I don't think that's a thing that you can do, build it down, but you know what I'm saying. Like, you can make it really subtle or you can make it really intense, and these last all day. They're really good for oily skin that eats through any makeup you put on it. They will last, so I really like that about these. These are, I think, like 25-ish. I can't remember exactly, I'm sorry. But again, they'll be linked below. Okay, now all I have is lip products left. First, I'm gonna talk about MAC lipstick. I know that this is really talked about on YouTube, like everyone has a ton of MAC lipsticks. And lately I've been seeing kind of mixed reviews on them. Some people say they're drying or whatever. That's not been the case for me. I don't find them drying. I actually find them really comfortable. I have a satin finish in Amorous and then a matte finish in Pink Plaid. This one is probably my favorite lipstick, at least as far as like traditional lipsticks in a tube go. This one is really pretty and it just kind of works for like an everyday nude shade for me. And then I have Amorous, which is a bit of a deeper red, kind of a red. It's not really, it's kind of more like a cranberry-ish shade. But anyway, I really love both of these. To me, they're both very comfortable. They last for a really long time. I love the packaging, how it just kind of looks so sleek and like classy. More than that, I love how comfortable the formula is for me, how it stays in place, and how pigmented it is and everything. And these just work really, really well for me. I really like them, so that's all I can really say about them. They are $17 a piece, I think, and I would say that they're worth the money. They're definitely my favorite lipstick formula. I lied. This was chilling in with all of the lip stuff, so I thought it was a lipstick for some reason, but this is the Too Faced Better Than Sex mascara. This is my favorite mascara of all time. I would open it up and show you the wand, but this one actually hasn't been opened yet. I've had a few little mini sizes. So again, I would recommend that you go for those first. They're like $12. You can get like the little mini size and it lasts a really long time. You can see how it works with your eyes and everything. But for me, I absolutely love this. I know it's been really hyped on YouTube, but definitely for good reason. The only thing I don't like about it is very flaky. You do get kind of flakes on your face. So there is kind of a little toss up with that. You do get really voluminous, long lashes, and to me, it's the best mascara that I have personally tried. Just, it makes my lashes look amazing, like almost like false lashes, and I barely have to put any effort into it. I just kind of put a coat on and go. Like, I don't even need two coats with this, which usually I do. But I really, really love this. Definitely recommend it. I know it sucks to spend like $20, I think is how much this is, $20 on a mascara, but if you can, then maybe just start out with the little one. It lasts a super long time, and that's only $12, so I mean, in my opinion, I would go with that one. Next, I have some liquid lipsticks from Kat Von D. This is the Everlasting Liquid Lipstick Formula. I have the shade Outlaw. For some reason it has something on it, and then the shade Double Dare. I love both of these shades so much. I know if I swatch them, they're going to stain my hand. They will not come off, so I'm not gonna do that. But this was actually the shade that my sister wore at her wedding, and she obviously kissed her groom, and she had cake shoved in her face and all of the typical wedding stuff. She was sweating because it was super hot. It was in Georgia and she had it outside, and this did not budge. It stayed on her mouth the whole entire evening or whatever. Like, her whole wedding, it stayed on perfectly. So that is like a true test to wear on your wedding. I love both of these shades. This is like a perfect true red, and then this one is kind of a rosy shade, and I really like it for fall. They do have really beautiful packaging. I think that these were like designed by Kat Von D. I think she designs all of her packaging and is really beautiful. Like I said, the formula is just amazing. It stays in place all day. It is drying, but most liquid lipsticks are, but it just stays in place all day so well, and I love it so much. When you need something to stay, last all day and not budge, this is definitely your kind of product. The last thing that I have are these Buxom lip glosses. I have a Buxom Full-On Lip Polish in the shade Celeste and a Full-On Lip Cream in the shade Dolly. Of both of these, I have Celeste on my lips right now. I'll actually just put a little bit more on because it's kind of fading. So I have this on over top of a lipstick. By itself, it's kind of just like really glittery. Like, it doesn't have too much pigment behind it. It's a very, very light pink with a lot of glitter on it, basically. But they do have a lot of shades that have more pigment behind them if that's more your jam. This one is a lip cream, so it doesn't have all the glitter to it. It's just a really nice sheen, and it is a beautiful mauve shade. They actually do have a lip polish in this shade as well. So that is it right there. You can see it has a bit more pigment to it. And it has a lot of shine, but it doesn't have the glitter that this one has, if you can see. They are plumping lip glosses. I know a lot of us ear plumping and we think burning, stinging, whatever, but these don't do that. They're actually super duper comfortable and really moisturizing. They definitely have that tingly feeling. It feels like mint, basically. It's very minty. I don't know how much it really plumps your lips. It definitely makes them look a little bit plumper because that's just what lip gloss does, but I don't think it really makes them any bigger actually. But for me, I love them because they are so moisturizing when my lips are just dry as a Sahara and I need some serious moisture. This is what I go for. It works every time. I think it is because it's so tingly and stuff. It just has something in it that makes your lips feel so much more moisturized, and it definitely keeps me from like biting at my lips, which I do all the time. But it's also just so beautiful either on its own or on top of lipstick or on top of any lip product that you want to put it on top of. It just looks really beautiful, and like the glittery one is really glittery, and like the glitter is really fine and just looks really plump. I have lipstick on my teeth and you guys didn't tell me. I thought we were friends here and you guys just let me talk with lipstick on my teeth. How rude. Anyway, back to the point at hand. The lip gloss is amazing. Obviously, if you don't like mint, if you don't like a tingly sensation, you're not gonna like this. But if you do like that and want something that looks really glossy and your lips look really plump and feel super moisturized, then this is definitely the lip gloss for you. I think it's the best lip gloss. It is the best lip gloss that I've ever tried. It's my favorite. I love it so much. Most lip glosses are kind of just like, meh, okay, they're good. I'm not that picky about most lip glosses. As long as it's not sticky or goopy or whatever, it's fine. But these are like amazing. Probably the only lip gloss that I would ever spend $20 on, but I would definitely do it again and again. I think other high-end lip glosses are kind of just like, they're the same sort of deal, they're just nice. But these are like so moisturizing and just feel so nice on the lips that I would pay so much money for them. They are my favorite, I love them so much. So anyway, that is all the high-end products that I have for you today that I think are worth the splurge. Let me know what other kind of videos you want to see from me in the comments. Make sure you leave a like on this video if you did enjoy it. Maybe I will do a part two at some point. Make sure you subscribe to see all sorts of different new videos from me. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you all in my next video. Bye guys!